undeniable that COVID-19 has caused a huge impact on businesses. There's so much uncertainty in the business climate that business leaders and entrepreneurs may find difficulty to resolve.
We do believe that over time, we will come out of this stronger. COVID-19 has also served to remind us the intricate relationship between healthcare and economic growth. And this, we believe, will further elevate healthcare to actually the core of public and private sector agenda in the years to come.
COVID just brought us forward 10 years or 5 years, you know.
Doctor community has embraced digital, and the discussions are currently centering around corona, telemedicine, you know, what's going to happen in the medtech sector to make basically better patient diagnosis, as Mervin pointed out, you know, for better patient outcomes. So I think that's where we are, and it's here to stay.
They've seen a 50% increase in terms of people who are saying that they are very willing to use digital health tools. And if they assume that they are able to use something that's covered within their corporate insurance plan through the employer or through their own insurance plan, then the number actually goes up to 91%.
The whole COVID situation opened up a lot more opportunity for us. We are also very glad that we can really make a difference in this space.
This crisis has really, really sharpened focus.
So communications obviously is key, it has always been, and I think COVID-19 just brought that to a priority for all companies. I think on the supplier side, when we're selling to hospitals, we think it's important to communicate and reiterate and actually make our customers feel confident that we've got their backs.
So the other part that I really would like to really focus on moving forward is to really carefully plan out the messaging internally within the team. So at the end of the day is how do we input sensitivity and empathy into what we want to strategize in terms of internal communications.
Broadly, we are essentially addressing two things. Why would people work here? And why would our customers continue to use our products? In my opinion, internal communication is far more important than external communication. When we look at our communication strategy, it is the content part. There are four elements fundamentally. One is that we remain very authentic. The second is making it timely and frequent. The third element is balancing formal communication with informal communication. We need to continue to maintain that collegiality in our communication. And lastly, on that dimension, having communication at all levels.
Thank you so much, everyone, for attending this webinar. Businesses need to remain agile and prepare for future crises, and we hope we have provided useful insights to our audience today. My name is Priyanka Bajpayee, and reach out to SPAG if you have any questions about communication strategy in these testing times and ahead.